Yellowstone Lake is a very active lake. There are all kinds of geologic and biological processes going on right now today. So it's a significant contributor to the whole hydrothermal system in Yellowstone, and it plays a very important role in the geoecology. These processes range from simple hydrothermal vents on the floor of Yellowstone Lake to more complex systems like hydrothermal explosion craters with numerous active hydrothermal vents. We have the siliceous spires. We also have landslides that have flowed into the lake. The geology of Yellowstone Lake can be broken out into two basic domains. You have the northern two-thirds, which has been influenced by volcanic and hydrothermal processes, and you have the southern one-third, which has been influenced by glaciation. And then the entire lake has been affected by tectonics. Yellowstone Lake has many hydrothermal features in it. In our mapping, starting in 1999, going to 2003, we were able to identify more than 650 hydrothermal vents and more than five active hydrothermal explosion craters. One of the most interesting discoveries we found in our Yellowstone Lake surveys was that we identified a series of structures that are in the northeastern part of the lake that are siliceous spires. And these spires are made up of silica. They are associated with hydrothermal vents. We can see that they are located in these hydrothermal vent craters or depressions, and that these structures look like conical features that are made up of filamentous bacteria and diatoms. And they're completely cemented with amorphous silica. And we've determined that the ages of those spire features are about 11,000 years old. So that's about 5,000 years after the last glaciers retreated from Yellowstone Lake Basin. The one behind us here is called Indian Pond Hydrothermal Explosion Crater, and it is about 2,900 years old before present. It's about 800 meters in diameter. These are the events that we are have a lot of concern about and have a high probability of happening, you know, in our lifetime, much more than a volcanic eruption. These are our large hydrothermal explosion craters in Yellowstone. And you can see how much larger the ones we have in Yellowstone are compared to those throughout the world. One of the studies that we would like to do in Yellowstone Lake would be to monitor these hydrothermal domes and hydrothermal systems a little more. And so what we want to do is deploy several geophysical instruments such as ocean bottom seismometers, tilt meters, chemical instruments such as pH meters, instruments that will allow us to measure the temperature of the geothermal fluids as they're coming out of the hydrothermal vents. And we plan on deploying these instruments at three major places in Yellowstone Lake and leaving them on the floor of Yellowstone Lake for a year so we can look at the various seismic events that happen during the year. We can look at how lake level changes and affects the hydrothermal vents. And we can also look at how seasonal changes with lake level lowering and rising have an influence on the hydrothermal vents. As a geologist, it's very rare that you get to see active processes in front of your eyes. And the fun thing about Yellowstone Lake was that when we were mapping it, we saw these active processes happening right in front of us. And most of us geologists, we look at things that formed millions of years ago, and we're left to thinking, well, what were the processes that were involved here? And so in Yellowstone Lake, we have multiple geologic processes operating, and then we have overprinted on this a very active biological community.